What is going on, guys? We're doing another live stream. And today's going to be a gas mask. I've already done this section. It's healed nicely. A little scene there with a little girl. Try and turn this light down a bit. There you go. Little girl. It's fully healed. Blacks have stayed in real nice. So yeah. Just quickly give you a little look. Nice little grass textures at the bottom. So yeah, that's healed. I'm going to add this to the top. And this is my reference. So yeah, we're just going to go through with it now. Hey ma'am, hey Mockybird. So these are the needles I'm using. Using the Vertix, you can see that Vertix. 15 curve mag, this is a bug pin. I'm using 11 curve mag, Vertix, and I'm using Quadrin 4-round liner. And I'm using a 9-round liner in a Quadrin as well. This is the stencil stuff I used, which is Nico Hurtado's Ancud, which is, in my opinion, the best stencil stuff to use. It doesn't budge.
Right, are you ready?
Ready or not, Bobber?
Let's do it.
Please. More, sir.
What's that?
Walking Sideman
number 7,
I'll
speak for more.
Yeah. Why is he asking for more? Cut him out of the scene, cut him out.
Let's see the season go ahead.
Christ, that was a bit loud, wasn't it? Can you come down a tiny bit more? Mm-hmm. Yeah, is that all right, yeah?
Yeah, is that
all
right?
Yeah, that's perfect, mate.
He told the truth. And basically he said...
Just spin this around a bit.
...a quick fix at Manchester United. It's about the right players with the right attitude. And if there's doubt there shouldn't be doubt there. Money is there for the right players. Now that sounds like a really diplomatic answer, and this is where people are saying you got a bit of fun.
Yeah, that's fine.
It wasn't as...
Only because...
It didn't make a lot of sense.
Yeah, how about it?
I don't know what's
coming. We've only spent 66 million. Yeah,
okay. Right. And, you should have got numbing cream. Do you know the numbing cream I've been saying
to
that?
To be fair, even though it's quite intense, it's kind of manageable still.
Okay.
It's weird to explain.
Okay, cool. Yeah, as long as you're sweet.
No,
I'm going to start with the 4-round liner. Here we go. You ready? Solid black now. I'm starting with solid black. Just going to outline this. Lower tube.
So with that answer, you're telling us
like
so. There was money available to bring two midfielders in, but you didn't buy midfielders because they didn't have the right attitude and there was doubt. Right. So there was no midfielders in the whole world that you thought fitted Manchester United because you had an element of doubt. That's where the answer becomes silly because. And he also said, so you're happy to stick with what you've got then? You know, happy to go with what I've got. So you're telling me there's not one midfielder in the world football that's better than Matic, or Fred, or Pereira, or Tommy. Like, there's no midfielder out there in the whole world.
In the whole world? Sounds
just
like a fucking baby, doesn't it?
So, but I'd get his pain, man. There's money there for the right players.
How's it feeling, bro?
Yeah, it's
alright. It's alright,
yeah? And there's not one available in the whole world. And you know, obviously, when they are the same,
I'm just going to do this tube bit, and then I'm going to come down here. If I say stuff that doesn't correspond with anything we're talking about, bro, it's because I'm talking to the camera. Yeah.
Reece Gregory says, trying to play fast counter-attacking football with the front three with Nemanja Matic, Static will be suicide. That was the one piece of position for me that we needed. Nick Harrington says, happy to move on and get kind of with what we have. He plays high press though, Matic can't be shoehorned here. He's different players. And Richard Jameson from Newsbeat says, everyone was saying Bruno was his third best signing for us. He was linked to Spurs and Liverpool. No one made a big reason for that. Well, I think everyone's got to move on from Bruno Fernandes. I was thinking about it on the train this morning. I'm very disappointed we didn't sign him. He ended up staying at Sporting Lisbon. You can't, it's not, to me, it's not about Bruno Fernandes. It's about there wasn't one midfield as suitable for Manchester United's midfield. Tommy Grit says that I thought Ollie was very, very sheepish today. I thought he started off well, and then I think he got a little bit flustered and frustrated with the fact that there's a lot of people talking about this transfer window and they're frustrated with it. Look, what I would say is we've got to go with what we've got. There is no. Everyone's going to be disappointed about that transfer window. We've got to go with what we've got. We've got to summon up.
How are you all doing, guys? If you've got any questions, give me a shout while I'm doing this.
I'm excited about that Chelsea game. I'm apprehensive, but I'm excited because it's a new season and it's a new start. And you never know. Like, the message from the club is this. You know, whether it's in the press conference or the press leaks or whatever, the message from the club is this. They're very excited with the way the tour went. They're delighted with the three signings. There's going to be a change.
Needles, no, this is a four-round liner, man. And I've got a nine-round liner.
Where it's going. It's never going to be a quick fix. And, you know, we're excited for the season ahead. And Ole Gunnar Solskjaer said, we're confident about the season ahead. Most fans quite rightly think we're going to finish fifth this season. So if the club are confident and happy and positive, surely they think we're going to do better than fifth. And if we do better than fifth, then that's going to be higher than what we're expecting anyway, which means we're going to have a better season than we expect. So, look, maybe it can be that positive season. Maybe it can be. I mean, everyone's got a right to... Look, I would say to Manchester United Football Club, if you're trying to tell us to be confident and happy and this, that and the other, my answer personally would be, why would we trust you? We've had 6 years of bad decisions within the club. The spend is abysmal for a club of that size. Like, it's an absolute disgrace what's been spent. It's appalling. And the trust has gone because the players haven't delivered. You can get that trust from that, but don't dictate to us at the start of the season we should all be happy and confident. That's just naive. You're going to have
Yeah, Mariam F, yeah, that's right.
If you build it, we're all going to be happy. So go out on the most important thing is the football pitch and the matches we play on that. If they start winning games and playing well and it's still going, for me, it can't be the first 10 games. Even if we win the first 10 games, we're going to enjoy it, but I'll be like, where's the drop off then? We have 3 months of this under Ollie and we dropped off. We started seasons well under Mourinho and we dropped off. We need to play well from August to May. And if we do that and next May, happy days. No one's going to be more happy than you and me. So that's what the club need to do. If they can't create positivity, and if they're frustrated because fans are frustrated and negative, they can only change that around by performing on the pitch. And I'm only going to tell you, I realise that, and he said that himself. The only way we turn this around, because he was asked about the summer, the frustration of the board, and he said it quite rightly, the only way we can turn this around is on the football pitch, in the way that we play, because Manchester United fans will always respond to that, and we will, and that's where we are. So the frustration and the negativity is justified, but we go with what we've got, and my stance, as I said to you last night, when I reacted to the transfer window, is that any frustration should be aimed at the board, because they are the ones with the purse strings, and they are the ones who've not put the money into the club. I don't necessarily believe Ole Gunnar Solskjaer when he says the money's there, because if it was there, why didn't you buy a midfielder? You can't hide behind we couldn't find the right midfielder. The world has got a lot of midfielders in it. There's loads of midfielders that are better than what we've got, and obviously we didn't get them because there is a budget, because if the money's there, pay $120 million for Brighton. You know, we haven't got $120 million for Brighton. So, it's a flawed argument, and Ollie did look flustered, but it's not his fault. Bradley says, I think Ollie's saying he has targets, but they weren't available. Sally put them themselves, and the ones that were aren't the right players. There's always a price and a player that you do. John Lee says, I'm extremely disappointed. What are the chances of Pogba putting a transfer request? He has 5 to 6 years left at the top. Why should he stay? Pogba cannot leave. A lot of people were talking about this last night at the get-together. Pogba cannot leave. If Pogba leaves, however bad you feel now, it's going to get worse. That midfield is got, you know, we are one injury away anyway from that midfield being screwed. So, you know, Pogba cannot leave. Would you take Zidane if Ollie was sacked, says Dean Bayassi. Look, I think we'd be in a very different situation if Ollie and Solskjaer hadn't had such a good season and deserved to be on the job. I think we would have gone for a big manager, and I think if we'd got a big manager, we would have spent more. Hand on heart, I would say, if Ollie hadn't done well as an interim manager, and we'd got Pochettino, we would have spent 200 million. Because Pochettino would have said, I'm only having this job if you give me 200 million. The issue was, Ollie did fantastically well and he got the job, but he's young, he's inexperienced, and the board basically went, yeah, you're just having a good job. And I think he got played a little bit there, but I wanted Ollie to get the job. Isaac Scott says, Woodward needs to focus on sponsor deals and that stuff. Send a direct football to solve the transfers. Don't blame Ollie, he can't do anything. I agree. Mr. Beast, I know we shouldn't be leaving on chance, but Scott, Brennan, Andres Pereira might play well this season. Same time, there isn't Kenny Finch's FC need to spend. Yeah, the issue with that, Mr. Beast, is that there are a lot of players in Manchester United's squad this season as we look ahead to Chelsea. I'm doing a preview later. And the season in general, we've done our season preview, we'll put that up later. There's too many players, I think, that we're hoping are going to go from potential to consistency. McTominay, Fred, Herrera, Rashford, Martial, all the young players, even Pogba, none of them have ever shown any consistency in the United shirt. And you're suddenly expecting 10 players, even Lingard, to show consistency. Because if they could all show consistency, we'll be fine. It's the inconsistency that we struggle with. And when, you know, if you want one or two players to show consistency, you might get away with it. When you've got 10 players that you're hoping are going to go from inconsistent to consistent, it's a big ask. And that's why Ole Gunnar Solskjaer deserves a statue to get top four. I agree with Ollie, we need the players that will be a part of what we are building. So as disappointed as I am, I'll wait for them to have players wanting to be on the same page. Players as out of the division. Yeah, but Middleton, the problem with that is, you're telling me there wasn't one midfielder in the whole world that was the right player to come. Every one of them had a bad attitude. It's, I think what happened is there was a couple of players that United highlighted that had the deal fell through. I suspect we'll have a better season than last, but Rashford, Martial, Lingard and Sanchez must step up. None were good enough last season. And on the subject of Alexis Sanchez, I think he's been the biggest flop Premier League's ever had. But we've got to get behind him and hope he delivers, because we haven't really got any other choice. George Kyle, if players are leaving, we'll have to replace them. And you would be surprised who wants to join us. Unfortunately, people believe in hope rather than logic. And that's a quote from Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, isn't it? He said, players leave, we'll have to replace them. Didn't replace Herrera. I mean, that's a very good point from George Kyle, because I've forgotten about that quote. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer did say, if players leave, we'll replace them. Bellamy left, not been replaced. Herrera left, not been replaced. Lukaku left, not been replaced. Three key positions not been replaced. Quality players want to come to this club, you'll be surprised. Where are they? Scott Cook, God help us if our back four gets injured, they will be under siege all season with no protection from the field.
Happy birthday, Jordan. Cliff Jordan just said happy birthday, bro.
Yeah, okay.
Oh, is it? Sit. Awesome, man.
I disagree with that.
Yeah, my client's birthday today, so wish him happy birthday, guys. He's spending his birthday with me getting tattooed. Lovely jubbly.
Because it's just giving you hope. Because nothing's going to happen in January that's significant. And even if it does, it's too late. KB Amoa says, I feel Pogba is faking injuries to prevent a harsh reception from Atlanta on Sunday. I didn't even know Pogba was a potential injury doubt for the game on Sunday. But let me just say that. I don't want to just be, look, it's all the forward's fault, it's not Ollie's fault, you know, let's get behind Ollie and all that. That's very important. But what I will say is this. Ollie Gunnar Solskjaer is the man I want to be Manchester United manager. I want to back him, I want him to do well, I want him to be here for years, and I want United to get back where they want to be. And there's a but. The but is this. If he starts picking Matic and Mata, that's nothing to do with the bad transfer window. There are different players he can play. You don't need to play Mata. You can play Lingard, you can play Gomez, you can play... You don't need to play Mata. You don't need to play Matic. You can play Pogba or Fred or McTominay or Pereira. He chooses to play people like Mata and Matic ahead of the other players. That is on him. That is his choice. That is down to the manager. So I'm not going to say this season, if we have bad results, I'm just going to go, it's the board's fault, it's the board's fault, it's the board's fault. If only going to start, if we lose matches, and Mata and Matic are playing over the likes of Tommy, Fred, and Pereira, Gomez, and Lingard, then that's on the manager. I personally do not think Matic and Mata offer us anything when we've got players that should, basically, we've had a bad transfer window, right? If Ole Gunnar Solskjaer and Manchester United want to build something and they want patience, then play Gomez, play Greenwood, play McTominay, play Pereira. Don't not have them on the bench or on the bench to play old-timers that are not part of the future and are on the decline. That's the only thing I'm going to say before the season starts about Ole out. I want to back him. We all want to back him. We all want to have a siege mentality and just say, screw the board. We'll go with what we've got. But if we go with what we've got, let's go with something that's exciting. Gomez is better than Matic. McTominay is better than Matic. Go with those players. Yes, they're going to have to learn on the job, but we'll be patient with that learning. We're not going to be patient with players that shouldn't be here, that are on the decline, and are basically blocking those players that we want to invest that time in. I really hope, now the transfer window's over, and Ole Gunnar Solskjaer said it himself in the press conference, I'm glad it's over. I'm glad it's over. You're glad it's over. We didn't get what we wanted, but I'm glad it's over because it was a circus. I'm glad it's over. Now it is over. We know the squad. We know what we do. I just hope and pray Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, when he picks his team against Chelsea, he thinks, I'm not going to go with tried and tested experience. I'm going to go with a new way of playing. Because if Chelsea do beat us, but I play an exciting team, these fans are invested in me. If we lose to Chelsea and I play Matic and Mata, they're going to go, oh, it's the same old nonsense, it's the same old has-beens, taking the place of the players that can be. That's my only concern about that. And the rest of it, I agree with. The board haven't backed him, you know, and it's not been the sum of the bottom. But he could pick a really exciting side up someday. I'll show you when I do the Google later. Zine Mayati says, I think it's sad what's happened to Manchester United and Arsenal. I wish Manchester United and Arsenal would both do well, as that's when it's most exciting. I don't see any reason why Arsenal aren't going to do well. I think we've got a very good transfer window, way better than they thought we could have. Welcome to Chuck Lee, the latest man of the United States Members Club. And AB says, I too really want to be a midfielder, plus we are very light in attack too. All the players we signed are quality players who wanted to come, so it's pretty sure all the people were expand. Look, I can't wait to see how quiet play. Can't wait to see Harry Maguire. We've seen a bit of James, we've seen about Lambert after. Harry Maguire is going to make a massive difference to our defence. What I would say is, with Lukaku gone, there's no more, when the team news comes out, Lukaku starts and Martial's on the bench. We haven't got that anymore. There's no more Romans when his first touch bounces off and smashes the bloody steward. That's gone. And whatever you think about Sanchez, he's highly frustrating, but if he plays well, the style of football is very easy on the eye. Martial and Rashford are exciting players. Greenwood's an exciting player. If Sanchez finds some form, he's exciting, he's just infuriating in the ball. Lukaku was just a nightmare to watch. He's gone. So whatever you feel about the consistency of the attack, it's an exciting attack. Like, I can't promise it's going to be well, but it is exciting. The way we play from back to front, it should be exciting. The only fear with that team is Matic.
How you feeling, bro?
Taking the ball onto him. Yeah,
How sore is it? Is it alright?
Yeah, we've certainly got to obviously not play another, but...
Yeah, standard, isn't it?
Just go with Fred or Matomi next to Pogba and try and get some speed from back to front, because that's our strength this season. We've got a very strong defence, and you should be soaking up pressure and getting things into the break.
What's that got to do? Got to do with it?
Ollie will start the devil there, but he has pressure on him. He talks about Newt last season and then played against Samuel Ott. Well, he did say in the press conference that Mason Greenwood would have, his path would have been blocked by the Garfield. He'll play a lot of football this season. I would start him on Sunday. I really, really would. Lukaku did score a lot of goals for us, and we've got to find a way of replacing that this season. Ollie said, you want to put it right, we do that on the pitch with that style of play. The team and the club feels very, very confident. We've got, there's a cloud over the club at the moment, and that was his response to that. We must put it right. On the park, he said it was time to go. Everyone's happy with that deal. He's happy, everybody's happy. And with regards to transfers, as I said, he says that the club, they don't feel the frustration that the fans feel. And that, you know, he's happy with the squad and believes and trusts in the squad. What's changed in 4 months, Ollie? You know, 4 months ago, you didn't believe and trust in the squad. You said some of them were going to have to go. They are still here. I believe that's because we can't sell it. You know, Romo should be here. You can't sell it because the contract he gave him is ridiculous. He's on ridiculous money. Matt Sanchez, we can't sell him because he's on ridiculous money. The problem is, when, I think Darmian finally will go at some point, and that will expect that even more, but United find it so hard to sell players because one, the world knows they're rubbish, and two, they're also on stupid way to pay some players. Right, Vishal Oran says all of this is bullshit. If you wanted to be good, you would spend money all around the pitch, but the board just invested to show it tends to fans who don't understand and not make the team better. Look, there was a I'm going to say this right now. I ridiculed this in the summer. I think it was Mark Ogden in the ESPN around May or June. Right, we spent £145 million on James Wan-Bissaka at the wire. We did spend £145 million. But then we sold Lukaku, and that halved what we spent because we got £75 million back. Our spend this summer was about £70 million. And so our budget for this summer was less than £100 million. That's Manchester United Football Club. Sixth best club in England, in the Europa League. The biggest club in England, massively, massively underachieving, spends £75 million to try and turn things around. It's a joke. It's a joke. And you don't replace Fellaini, Herrera, and Lukaku. Like, you can talk about rebuilds all you like. You can talk about it not being a quick fix. But that transfer...
Thanks, El Pinche Monte, Lil D.
Has
it? Mouthful.
Unless you turn up and show us that girl.
Oh boy.
I don't believe you. So, like, yeah, there's money there to be spent. Prove it. Oh, I can't now. The transfer window shut. Yeah. It's all make believe, isn't it? If you've got
money, go and spend. He's hilarious, isn't he, this geezer? Such a character as well. He's so funny. He's like analogies on like how he explains stuff. It's crazy. Christian Sismak. Thanks, man. Thanks for the love. Thanks for the support.
Sorry if I don't believe that there's money to be spent. I don't believe it until the club evidence it. And look, the club can get really frustrated with that. They could be there going, we really tried to buy this player. We really tried to buy this player. Sorry, after 6 years, don't trust you. And that is where I am as a United fan at the moment. I want to believe. I want to be positive. And I want to love and appreciate and buy into what the club's trying to do, apparently. But, and they may well be trying to do all those things. And they may well do all those things. But...
Hello, Denog DJ from Brazil. We've got 71 people live, 72 people live. Please smash a like on the video. It'll help me out loads. If you want to ask me any questions, feel free. Yeah, machine. Don't call it a gun. It's like a swear word in this industry. But in all honesty, you can call it whatever the fuck you want to call it, man. Cheers, Rokiki, not 1993. Ooh, it just knocked my thing. Stuart McAdams, cheers, man. I'm going to try and do one every day. Every day I tattoo, I'm going to try and do a little live stream for you guys.
Merchandise, we've got lots of. I'll be back live at 8 o'clock tonight. We've got previews coming up to the Chelsea fan channels.
Paulinho, thank you, my man. Thanks for tuning in. Hope you have a good day or a good night wherever you are. Sounds like you're in Brazil.
But we go with what we've got. We've got to back manage, we've got to back players. Let's see what they give us over the next coming weeks and months ahead. I am excited about it. I just wish we'd run into this season more. And I think the big theme that I'm going into with this season is I just don't want to listen to the positivity from the club. We're going to do this, we're going to do that. Talk is cheap.
Douglas Vega, thank you so much for the support, man. How you feeling, bro? You right, yeah? You good, yeah? Are you on the phone?
Yeah.
Oh, right. Huh? Yeah, no, you're sweet, man. I thought you might be talking to yourself like delirious or something. I was like, oh shit.
No,
sweet.
No, I was just saying
if you
wanted to.
Roman Bojic, yeah man, I'm good. How are you? Stefan, thank you so much, my man. everyone that's watching the live stream, can you smash a like on the video? That would help me out a lot. We've got 80 people watching, 23 likes. Good, bro. I'm good. I'm glad you're good. Yes, thank you guys. I can see the likes going up. 31 likes. Sick. I've never had 100 likes on a video during a live stream, which would be pretty cool. Or even 100 people were tuning in all at once. So we might break a record today. Smash that like button. You're close to 100. So close, man. What do you want me to explain about it, man? Like, I'm using solid black dynamic ink here. This is a 11 curve mag from Vertix, and the machine is a injector running at 13 volts today. It's a Inkjector Flight Elite. It's the black edition as well, if you can see it. It's this one. I'm running at 13 volts. Yeah, normally I run it at 12, but because I wanted to smash this black in pretty solid, I'm just running it a bit faster today. I've also changed my cam on the machine. So my cam in this part here, the gold part you can just see in there, that's changed to a 2.5, which makes it a lot smoother for shading and stuff. You see less needle mark kind of thing. It was a standard, I think it's 3.25, so. Add some texture now. Diego, yeah, man. About the cam, go on, Bogdan. So for this texture in here, I'm going to use my stippling technique. Yeah, a four millimeter hits harder. Yeah, it does. So I'm just going to use this stippling technique to do this bit. Just going in like this. Coming in at an angle, coming out at an angle, like almost like a brush, yeah? And then I use lighter tones around.
Exactly as we did a year ago, with about £70 million spent, with not enough done,
and not really any hope. The only difference this time is we haven't got a manager on the media telling us it's not good enough and we're going to struggle this season. Instead, we've got a manager who's going to roll out tomorrow in the press conference and be super positive and tell us everything's fine. I'm really happy with the boys. They've worked really hard. Because everything's going to be different, everything's going to be fine. The difference between this year and last year is Ole Gunnar Solskjaer is the right man with the wrong tools. Ole Gunnar Solskjaer will be positive, Mourinho and Julio are smart.
Right, man, Bodic, it's all good, man.
But with Manchester United this year, I can see the same season as next year. If you look at our rivals and what they've done, Chelsea haven't done anything, but I think Chelsea know they haven't done anything, so I think they're dangerous because they'll have camaraderie. They'll have transfer that. They've got a new manager, they've got some good young players. Arsenal have had better transfer windows. Pepe, Tierney, David Luiz, the lads from Real Madrid, better transfer window than this. The Spurs have had better transfer window.
Yeah, yeah, so no, it was a bit of a medium tone I used that texture with. Yeah, I didn't use full black. I'm probably going to use full black in here though. This is full black in my needle now, just because I can see there and there is full black. I'll just stipple up from here as well. Because it's quite dark around this area, so I do full black down here. It's better. Thanks, Ruthie. Thank you, Jinta. Does voltage affect the whip shading? Yeah, you need to move your hand faster. If it's a faster voltage, a higher voltage, you need to move your hand faster. So, yeah. Make sure as well, when you're tattooing, sometimes, because I use Vaseline on the skin, your cartridges can get blocked. Just make sure you wipe them down so the ink flows nice and smooth. Mm. Do it while it's going as well. Good morning, Frank Montoya. It's Frankie boy. Yeah, I like to do hand stencils just because I can pick everything out that I want to pick out and leave bits I don't want to put in. Just personal preference, man. I haven't used a Quadrant Proton Mix, man. Ruthie, that's funny. Yes, I do. Dinog DJ, I use that type of technique for the Tiger Nose as well, yeah. Smash a like on the video, guys. Help me out. Help a brother out. I just want to see after a few things. Yes, it is, Jinta. My whole speed in this tattoo will be the same. I'll just adjust my hand speed accordingly. I haven't used the inkjet stencil, Bogdan. I think we lost each other there for a minute. Making this by hand, it took about 20 minutes. Thank you, MG Sini. Jinta, yes, I do. I do record this. This is currently recording straight onto the onto my page now. FPV Stu, no, I think it's just literally how, because this motor in this is very high. It's got a very high voltage rate on it, so, but I've used rotaries before that only run at 4 volts and they're still quick, you know. It literally just depends on how the machine's built. I don't really know much about coils. I think coils sort of run at a lower voltage, I think, but again it depends on how the machine's made, but generally speaking inkjectors run quite high. Thank you very much for that donation, Paul Paulinho. I really appreciate that. How many passes? I like to give them 2 passes. I like to give grey wash tattoos 2 passes just because I feel like, you know, I can make a good tattoo in 4 hours, but if I spend 8 hours on a tattoo, it just makes it a lot better. Right now I'm using a 4-round liner. You see what I'm saying? Like, at the end of the day, we're not going to be many cocktails. It's a bit red. My client's skin can go quite red, which is normal, but it heals nice. If you can see this bit here, it heals very nice. So yeah, don't be alarmed why it's so red. Bro, can you just turn your leg this way a bit? That's it. Yeah. I don't know why my fucking internet keeps lagging out, man. I'm back. My internet keeps going wrong, which is weird. I'm not too sure what's going on. Cheers, Dinog GJ, for tuning in. Appreciate that. Have a good day, man.
running.
Hello, Brian Gonzalez Munoz. It just depends, man. But pricing depends on how much detail and how many days it's probably going to take, etc. I normally charge by price. How's it feeling, bro?
Yeah, alright.
Just whack your leg over a bit more. Can you go even more? Turn it.
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, that's alright. Okay. Yeah, that's it. Yeah, sweet. That's the kitty.
Hey, Adrian Schwinkel. I use dynamic black ink. Thanks, Douglas Vega. Thanks for the support, brother. If anybody's going to the London Tattoo Convention, I'll be about for a drink and a talk too, if you want to meet me there. Ryan, are you going to London Tattoo Convention?
I'm not, but I want to.
Yeah, it's pretty cool, man.
I really want to go one day, yeah.
Every September, last weekend in September.
Oh, Tobacco?
Tobacco Doctor,
yeah. No, I was thinking of going one day, man. It'd be good.
Yeah, it's sick.
Just appreciate different work, don't
I? Yeah, man. Oh, mate, the vast majority of work there is just fucking sick as well. Like, proper, proper cool stuff. Thanks, Augustin Gutierrez. That's a cool name.
That's like brilliant.
I don't know. Sounds like a Mexican drug lord's name. Did you used to work for Pablo Escobar? It's a German name, brother. Nobody can spell it. Schwinkel. That's cool, man. Half Mexican, I thought so, man. Gutierrez is very Mexican, isn't it? Makes sense then, makes sense. What's love got to do with it? Everything all right? Ryan?
Mm-hmm.
Good.
You know, as it's going on, it's feeling as bad as it's going on in the beginning. Shot.
Yeah.
It was a bit worse, but now it's kind of, you know, getting into a groove. Sort of,
yeah, man.
Getting into a rhythm.
I feel that. I feel it, man. Ginta Juna, I'm from Holland. There we go. I mean, the skin's pretty red. It's not as red as I thought it was going to be, but just because I'm being gentle on the skin, really.
And because that's his name.
And it's your very good skin, Ryan.
Indeed.
Right, if you can go even more over, you keep slipping back, bro. That's the kiddie. Right. Yeah. A bit more, you've gone back again. You'll have to turn it onto your side, yeah, instead of
right.
A minute.
That
yeah,
is?
Yeah, that's perfect.
Sweet.
Sugar on a waffle. There's no pleasing you. I love that fucking film, man. It's so good. Sugar on a waffle, a bong and a blitz. A cigarette and a crepe. Well, there is no pleasing you. Oh, God. So funny. Yeah, man, you have to have a laugh, you know. You have to chat, sing, fart, take the piss, shit on a client, you know. I'm joking. Never do that. That's very unsanitary.
I had a shower before I came in. Now I didn't
know. And now I, yeah.
One that's gold might work, right?
What's Lave get to do?
My father is providing live IT support.
Really?
For your glitchy streaming issues.
Really? What's he saying?
He's like, I'm still watching it on and off, so just some of it does a clean up on his computer, it may benefit the streaming.
It's the phone.
But
Spanner in the works.
Shit.
Yeah, no, I know it's bad. It's the internet connection, I think, here. Sometimes it's really good, sometimes it's like super fast, it's like fiber and stuff, so super
fast. I watch at work and stuff, like, as you probably didn't even notice, but I watch at work and sometimes,
nice,
yeah, sometimes it was, it looks a bit sort of, it's like perfectly crisp, sometimes, yeah, it's a bit
blurry.
But yeah, but it's all right, though, it's still legendary.
Are you watching it now?
No.
Oh, right.
No.
Ah,
Where's the support, man? Just kidding, just kidding.
I'm literally laying here.
Come on. Here. That's enough support for one day. I'm paying for your bills, you prick.
We're putting the damn table, man.
Yeah. Doing for the rest of the day anyway, man. Obviously you got the meal.
Yes sir.
Just chilling after that.
I'm gonna go home, relax the leg. Don't put too much stress on my bed.
Yeah, just air it, not air it, elevate it, bro. That's the best advice I can give.
My dad was talking about potentially taking me to a theme park tomorrow on Sunday, and I was like, absolutely not. You realize what you're saying?
I've never been to a theme park. Yeah, I've been to Wicks Theme Park. But I've not been to Thorpe.
What did you say, Wicks Car Park?
Wicks Car Park is the best place to go. You're missing out. This is a Quadrium cartridge, and these are Vertix cartridges. You can spell it like that, V-E-R-T-I-X.
Which you cannot get in the Wicks.
Yeah, you can't get in the Wicks because I'm in the car park. So if there's a queue in the Wicks, it's because it's me pretending it's fucking Wicksteed. That's Wicksteed. I don't even know where that is. I think it's like Northampton somewhere. It's pretty sick, man. It's pretty cool. It's like go-karts and shit there and that. But you can have like Grand Prix and that. Yeah. I don't think they are from FKI Irons Vertix. I think it's just their own kind of brand, but they're pretty solid. They're pretty nice to use. I don't think they beat Cheyenne though. Nothing beats Cheyenne shader cartridges just because they're so fucking good. Just so well made. Do you know what I'm saying?
I do, I know what you're saying.
I'm good.
Did you ever see that thing with Ali G where he tries to sell Trump like an idea of an ice cream?
Trump?
Yeah.
Nah.
And he's trying to like sell him a business idea of an ice cream club.
Ice cream plum?
Glove.
Oh.
So when the ice cream drips in it, it doesn't get on your hand. It just on this black marigold glove. It's amazing.
That's so funny.
And Trump's like,
it's just a black.
Why are we wasting our time listening to this?
Really? Shit.
And he just
really?
He's like, yeah, this is bullshit. Let's just leave. And just walked out.
That's so funny, man. Trump's awesome. I think he's fucking hilarious.
Yeah, I mean, Trump might have a bit of a bad mouth, but he's doing good things for that country, really.
I think he is. Yeah.
I love the way he said about Afghanistan. He was in Pakistan the other day doing some press conference, and he's like, "Yeah, if I wanted to win the war in Afghanistan, just give me 10 days and I'll win." And basically, what he's saying is, I'll just drop a fucking nuke on them and just.
Really?
Yeah, probably. Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah, probably, well, come on, he's on an aircraft carrier, probably with bombs on it.
Yeah.
And he's probably thinking, right, all I've got to do is tell him, right, fly over, drop a bomb, and then
so
fly
bad.
Off.
So bad.
And that's it.
Yeah. I mean, we shouldn't really be talking about this on live stream, considering I'm doing a war memorial piece.
What's your favourite fruit?
Favourite fruit?
Yeah, we just steer it off topic.
My favourite fruit is probably...
Dairy milk?
Yep. Dairy milk is my favourite fruit.
Yeah.
I like Galaxy as well.
Nice, rich and creamy texture.
Yep. Just like an avocado. Ooh. Do you like avocados?
Never tried one in my life.
You're kidding me. You are kidding me, bro. We can no longer be friends.
I'm literally not kidding.
We can no longer be clients, friends, nothing. Till you try an avocado.
Yeah, when you're handle service.
Today.
Get out.
Imagine if you end up being allergic and it kills you. That'd be so, but yeah, like start swelling up like anaphylactic shock. I don't know why you turn into a duck, but.
Yeah, that's one of the side effects.
Yeah, it's one of the side effects.
Slash duck shock.
Anaphyduck shock.
Do you know, ever since you showed me that video, that, would you look at that? I can't stop saying it.
It's so funny.
I'm at work and we get pictures of like paint and stuff, and like, would you look at that?
Oh, would you look at that?
You know what? I would have told him to look at it. He would go after it.
It's so funny. Do you know what I would do in that situation? Would you look at that? I'd tell him, would you look at it?
I don't even know that long.
Would you just look at it? Oh, it's so good, isn't it?
Oh, shit.
So funny.
Yeah, man, it's fucking good.
Would you just look at that?
Look at that.
Oh, so good, man. Thank you, Slave to Ink One. Slave to the Ink.
I
am a slave to the ink. I'm extremely slavelicious. Christ.
That's the best type of slave to be in, I think.
Yeah.
We should do a college course, I
should do a college course. Fucking
yeah, I now owe a really massive amount of money to the university because I've now got a degree on how to be a slave.
Yeah, yeah. It's so bad, isn't it? It's so fucking bad.
That's pretty much what it is anyway.
Is it a sex slave, though, or...?
Yep.
It sure is. Ding, 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 ding. You hit the jackpot question.
Well, it's like...
Place your words. Place
your words.
Yeah.
Do you think pulling the hair is okay? Only in sexual masochism is it okay?
Masochism.
It's like sexual masochism. Like, that sort of, you know. Have you ever heard him when he said Louis van Gaal's red arm?
No.
He's like, come on, Louis. Do you Louis van Gaal's red arm? He's like, Louis van Gaal's red arm. He's like really drunk sounding. It's great.
That's fucked. That's just fact.
You know what, right? He was a good manager, man.
Who was that? Louis van Gaal? Yeah, he was.
I think he was a rough time. What did they
got for? Yeah, I know. What the fuck was that? I was like, oh, if we win the FA Cup or win a trophy, he's going to be all right. And he wasn't.
Not today.
He fell to Edward Wood's hammer blow.
What a dick.
What a cock.
You doing that voice reminds me of Duke Nukem.
Duke Nukem. Yeah, he's sick. Duke Nukem, Land of the Babes. That is such a good... You had to just rescue fucking girls with their tits out. Like, like, you literally just had to do that. That was the whole idea of the game, was to just rescue girls from enemies with their tits out. Duke Nukem, Land of the Babes. Such a good game. I don't know how to read Japanese. Huang Ling Peng. Langping. I wish I could read that, man.
Do you know what? Funny you say about Japanese.
Can you read Japanese?
Because my colleague's wife is from Japan.
No way.
And he's gone there for 3 weeks.
Adrian Schwinkel, I know, it's a classic game, man. What's that, sorry?
My colleague's wife.
Oh, mate, it would be unbelievable.
So they've probably got one of the best diets in the world.
Yeah, just rice and fucking fish,
like,
isn't it?
Noodles and like ramen and like broths and just nice natural cooking. And the best thing about it is they're probably all grown themselves as well.
Yeah.
It's all processed.
Well, yeah, you have like rice fields and stuff, don't you?
Yeah, patties and stuff. Yeah. Actually, do you know where somewhere I would like to go? To New Zealand.
Yeah, me too.
Scenery. My God.
Yeah, don't get me started on New Zealand, but that's where my ex was from, so.
Alright.
Kind of a rough one.
Oh, is that the side of the mustache?
Yeah. It's alright, man, it's just these little coincidence things will just keep popping up as soon as we end. It just pops up, you know?
I guess, yeah.
Just little coincidences. Got to do
with thee. I just don't know.
It's got everything to do with it.
Yeah, why are you so naive, man? God,
yeah. Yeah. What else was a good game? Duke Nukem, Land of the Babes.
Do you know what they're remaking? Spyro.
Yeah, they've remade it, bro. It's already out.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Okay, mate, that came out months ago. That came out months ago. Yeah, no, it's good, man. Yeah, no, it's good. That was a good game, man. Very, very, really good game. Really good game. Really good game.
Oh,
it's
actually quite good. Mm, actually quite good.
Right.
You throwing me up?
No.
Oh, okay. I just can't see. So I'm assuming what's happening.
Well, you assumed wrong. Right, just turn your leg back round the other side.
What's not kicking it?
That's the one. That's the kiddie. That's the kiddie. Crash Bandicoot is definitely one of the best games. Just put your leg on this side. That's it. Well done, well done.
Crash or Sonic?
Crash, 100%. Yeah. Fuck Sonic, yeah. Fuck Sonic.
Screw you, man.
Fuck Sonic, man. Screw you, man. Screw you, man. What the fuck, man? Thank you for smashing likes on the video. Anybody else that's tuned in, let me see your support by smashing that like button. Smash it. It will do me a great deal of help. Hmm?
Oh, I'm calling myself a turd. I pressed the wrong button.
Yeah, it's easy. Oh, for God's sake. Yes, I have. Shane Hawk cartridges are very good. Probably some of the best. 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 Some of the best.
Hey, do you know they're remaking Adam's Family?
Are they actually?
I think they're making it animated.
Really?
Which
I think they've already done that, haven't they?
It's quite sad, actually.
Really?
Well, yeah, I mean, if something's as good enough as it is anyway, you see that, right?
Yeah, it's just nostalgic, isn't it? Some of the best, some of the best, some of the best. Bum, 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 bum. Some of the best. Some of the best. I need to stop that now because that's really in my head. I'm very fucking annoying. This is going to be a little bit of a bitch up here. Just because it's coming up to the behind the knee action.
Yeah, that's a shit.
Let me know if you want to stop, man.
No, it's not that it's like unbearable. It's just, you know, that intensity.
Sharp.
Yeah, it's just intense.
Real.
But other than that, it's fine. It's just like, ah. Yes, sorry,
says,
what was that, sorry? No.
He says.
You're free, that.
Yeah. What did you say? You said it was fine, right? Okay. Jeff Fafa?
obviously you can see it and I can't. Is it coming along quite nicely?
Yeah, we've just got the top to do, man. Just the eyes and the helmet. Bit of shading around the outside and we're sweet, man.
Oh my god.
We're flying through it. Flying through it.
Well, I'm in good hands,
right? Huh?
I'm in good hands, right?
Yep.
Oh, yeah, don't worry about that. You're in good
hands. Huh?
I said, oh, yeah, don't worry about that. You're in good hands.
You're in good hands, bro.
Well, let's keep this way. I wouldn't come back otherwise, would I?
No. You'd be like slagging me off on social media. He's fucking annihilated me.
What, yeah, hey, you said you liked it. What? What's this?
You said you liked it.
Double loyalty.
Fucking blackmail and crip.
He's blackmailed me, mama. What do I do?
You just go around in the house and burn it down.
Shit, you burn, you burn, honey, you just burn the house down and I'll be fine after that.
You know, like Jason's mum. You killed him, Jason. You got him. You killed him.
But that's just, but he's definitely
Wait, Mom,
a psychopath, though.
What? She's, what are you talking about?
Yeah, she's definitely a psychopath.
Do you think?
You think?
Yeah, she's actually nuts.
I think she's more nuts than him.
Oh, gotcha. Fucking hell.
Do you know what I mean, sir?
Yeah, Jason's fucking... The thing is, I like
he's just
about
big
Jason.
As well, isn't he?
Yeah, but the thing is about Jason that I like is that irrespective of how slow he sort of walks and whatever, he will get up. He's going to get up.
Yeah, it's because he like warps through time as well, doesn't he? Like, have you ever played them games, the Friday the 13th games?
No.
Mate, he just like, he jumps through time. Like, he'll like jump through the air, like teleport through the air, and then he'll just be there in front of you. It's like, doo-doo-doo-doo. You're like, fuck. Yeah, it's well hard.
The thing is with horror films, though, it's always the age old, oh, I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to go and hide upstairs where I can't escape.
Yeah, literally. That's pretty
that's,
much the
that's
game.
That's exactly why
that's
he can...
pretty much the game.
No, but that's the thing, though, isn't it? That's why he can walk after you.
Yeah.
He's like, I know these dumbasses are just going to walk upstairs. All I'm going to do is...
And it's normally like college people as well.
Yeah, like college
Hey, Cindy,
kids.
Should we hide upstairs? Yeah, I think we should, Brad.
It's like, not today.
Death to you, bitch, die.
It's like when he gets to bed, folds it up and crushes that guy like that's the other.
Oh, mate.
Have you ever seen Freddy vs. Jason?
Nah, never. Oh, I actually God, have never. Man. Is
hey,
it good?
Asshole. Up here.
Yeah, is it good, yeah?
Oh, yeah, it's a good film. It's funny. It's kind of funny. Kelly Rowland's in it. And she dies first. Obviously.
Kelly Rowland?
Yeah, she dies
oh,
first.
Oh, sick.
Yeah, she dies first.
She's so hot as well.
Yeah, there's a lot of
she's so hot, she's so spicy.
This is the thing, there's a lot of people out there you don't really think about.
Yeah.
They're like, when you see them,
like,
oh shit.
Oh shit,
it's kind like, of... For example, like, I don't watch a lot of music videos. If I was to like a song, go on YouTube, say, because I just listen to the radio.
Yeah.
And then you look at me and go, oh, that's what you look like. I have no idea you even...
Look like.
I mean, yeah. Ridiculous.
It's weird that, isn't it?
Mm. Like Rag and Bone Man.
Yeah, he's really big, isn't
like,
he?
He's a massive guy and his voice is awesome.
Yeah, he's sick.
I might go and see him later in the year.
Really?
Yeah.
That'd be really dope.
London somewhere.
Yeah,
he's probably soulful as well. Isn't
yeah.
He?
Yeah, he's sick. Very good voice.
I might take Steve as my date.
Steve?
Mm-hmm. Think about it.
Steve.
Yeah, think about it. Jacob.
Huh?
Steve. Come on, you must know what I'm talking about.
Jacob?
Yeah.
Oh, the...
Steve!
Right. The video.
I might take him on my date.
Wow.
That's my date. My
Jacob, husband.
I've literally had no idea what you were talking about. Until you said Jacob, and I was like, oh my god, it's him.
Like, person to person. Is that a genuine story?
Yeah, I think so.
Is it really?
I don't know. He could be bullshitting to me,
well,
but
I
believe
it. If he is, it's a great story. It's a brilliant story. If
I believed
that.
It.
You can't even write that, can you?
Yeah.
He
gets himself into some weird shit, man. Like, some crazy shit. Like, he's got loads of stories, man.
hilarious. I love a good story.
I love it when a good plan comes together.
My dad said my favourite bit so far is the shoes on the front.
Yeah, me too, man.
So, round of applause for you.
Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. What's his name? Cliff?
Yeah.
Thanks, Cliff. Shout out Cliff in the live stream. Cliff Richard.
Yeah, my dad's a bit like you, he's a bedroom DJ, like he's got a proper decks and stuff.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, yeah, he loves
what
it.
What decks has he got?
Pioneer.
Okay.
Yeah, he's got some Pioneer ones.
Nice, man. Did you see the live stream me mixing the other day?
Yes, I did. I didn't watch all of it, but obviously I didn't get managed to see all of it, so I've been busy, but yeah, I did see it. Nice, cool, man. Good to get yourself stuck into stuff as well, isn't it?
Yeah, stuff. I used to do it years ago, and then I just sort of kind of get back into it a bit.
But that's the point, that's the beauty of it being a bedroom, because you literally can, you've got full control of whatever you want.
Yeah, apart from my neighbour's like, shut the fuck up!
Oh god, yeah, my dad's like, please come round, and like the noise complaints, and they put decibel meters in the flats below and everything.
Really?
To try and catch them out.
Shit.
And then they come round with a decibel meter, and we're there, we've looked at it, it's fine. As you are, carry on.
As you are?
Yeah, love that.
I've had loads of new neighbours in the last few years as well, so that's probably why.
Yeah, because they probably just aren't used to it.
Fuck!
Because the thing is as well, it's not necessarily the noise, it's the bass.
Yeah, that's exactly
that's
what it is.
If you turn all the bass off, it's probably not actually that bad, really.
No, but it's so shit with that bass.
Oh yeah.
We need a buttery biscuit bass. How you doing, guys? Still tuned in? Yeah, we've got 80 people watching live. That's awesome. That is awesome, bros. Brez. Sound like PewDiePie now, bros. I really want to do a gaming channel as well. What do you think about that?
Yeah, I heard you say that. That's quite interesting.
What do you think about that?
So what? I know this might sound a bit stupid. What's like the kind of idea of it? Kind of just show you playing them or
yeah,
viewing them or
thing. I get quite involved on games, innit? So like, especially on Call of Duty, I'm like, it feels like a lot of people like playing with me because it feels like they're there. So I'm like, fuck, like, I'm getting shot, yeah. I shout so bad as well, like. So fucking bad.
No, that's not a problem. I think it's good though, you know?
It's good to have that, what's the word? It's good to have that passion, you know? Just turn your leg a tiny bit this way again. That's a bit too far. Tiny bit back. Yep.
That good?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Can I get my feels? You know you want some more, girl.
So come on.
So come on. Oh, you know that song, yeah. Can I get my feels? A little snag there.
Snag.
Snaggy root. Peggy Sue. Snaggy root. Peggy Sue.
Can I get my fizz? You know you want some more, girl.
Cleveland's coming in.
So come on. Can I get my fizz? You know you want some more, girl.
Do you know that reminded me of being a rescue ship from Norbit?
No.
You've ever seen Norbit?
No.
Oh, God.
I'm just a liability, aren't I?
Who also does good things with machines. Yeah, you're an absolute dick, but my god, can you do some work?
Oh, thanks, man.
Yeah, you're too kind. Laugh or cry. What's going on?
You're too kind, man.
No, it's true though. I don't think you probably won't ever remember the very first time that I ever came in here, ever with my left forearm. And I said to you that you were the only one that I felt basically could do what I wanted and that I trusted enough. And I was like, yeah, I'm coming.
Wow.
And that's why I've carried on to come.
Thank you, man.
That's the truth of it. To be honest.
You're very kind. You're very, very kind. Have you seen that YouTube video of a guy trying to cross a whole country in by foot in a straight line?
No.
Hilarious, bruv. He tries to cross Wales. Yeah. Well, yeah, he has to go like over fucking bushes, like through woods, fucking through people's houses. It's hilarious, bruv. He's filmed the whole thing. It's hilarious. So funny.
What happens when he gets the water?
He has to swim across.
Oh, just literally just
he gets to a lake, right? And he then stashes a dinghy and he fucking kayaks across this massive lake. It's so funny. I was like, oh my god, he's fucking crazy. And he's like, I'm getting seasick already because it's really choppy.
Oh god, yeah.
He's like,
Do you know what? Like white water rafting and stuff. I mean, it's dangerous as hell, but it'd be wicked to do it.
Oh yeah. White water. Rafting?
Yeah.
What's the white water bit?
Yeah, I don't know. It's just like, well, it's just water rafting, you know? It's just like proper choppy...
Choppy fucked up shit.
Yeah, just proper aggressive water and you're just bombing down.
Christ.
It's wicked. It's proper adrenaline rush.
Oh, yeah. Of drowning and dying and smashing your head on a rock that you couldn't potentially pass out from.
But amazingly, well, it's wicked.
Yeah, I feel that.
Well, my brother and I did a skydive.
Oh, fuck it. I was supposed to do a skydive when I was 18, for my 18th birthday, and I pussied out.
Oh,
yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
I would have thought you'd been already that.
Nope.
Really?
Love the idea.
Let's get high.
Jumping out of a plane with a parachute on.
Yeah. You can't get much more higher than that.
Yeah. I mean, I don't mind heights, but it's just the jumping out of the plane thing that kind of fucked me up.
No, I feel that. But it'd be... It's probably the best thing you've ever done in life.
Yeah, the best experience. I've heard that as well from people that have done it. Like, they say it's the best thing they've ever done.
Oh, hang on, we've got some Clifford information.
Really?
White water is the frothy bit that you see as the water.
Right, I thought it was. I was thinking that in my head.
Well, why do we have an interactive Wikipedia page?
Yeah, it's great, man. I love this live stream.
Very educational.
Yeah, for sure, man.
And if I didn't get that one earlier, you smashed your viewing record.
Did I?
I'm sure you said you've got the highest amount of views ever on a video.
At one time, I was hoping it was going to be 100, but it hasn't been that like that yet. Maybe it has.
Should I just come back tomorrow? Like, not even get anything done, just sit in the background and speak here. My presence will draw people in.
Yeah. That's absolutely fine, man.
As long as you match my day rate at work, it's fine.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah, sorry, I can't.
Which isn't that long.
But don't forget, it's all night long, though.
Yeah.
Until the morning.
Yeah, so, do you know that St. George's Hill?
Mm-hmm.
I had a geezer in here yesterday. It works on that site a lot.
Oh, really?
And they have security there, don't they? And he said they pay, each resident pays 10 grand a year for that.
Oh, just to have their presence?
Just to have a person at the front gate.
Oh, sweet. Oh.
That's fucked, isn't it?
Yeah, they must. Well, yeah, I suppose you've got to be like proper, not nervous, but you know, to have a security.
Yeah, and the thing is, people still get mugged on there as well, so it doesn't even work. Because they come through the golf course around the back.
Yeah, but don't forget, the whole point of their presence is a deterrent.
Yeah.
So if it's not enough of a deterrent, then it's just going to carry on, isn't
it? Yeah. Exactly, bro.
How's it feeling down here? What up here?
I can't really explain it.
Is it shit?
No, it's not as bad as... It's almost like... Are you on bone?
No.
You know, like when you're on bone, it kind of like hits it and vibrates off it?
Yeah.
It kind of feels like that.
Okay. Yeah, it's because I'm on a tendon, I think.
Yeah, it's really strange. Oh, yeah, well, I suppose it's the sensation of that, isn't
it? Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's really strange to explain. It's like really weird.
Yeah.
I chose to be.
Shit. This is your decision, not mine.
Thanks for the memories, thanks for the memories.
It's cool, man, don't worry about it.
Hello, Ray Kania. Can you? That's right.
Yeah, it's a bit cheesy in here, bruv. You've got stretch marks here as well. So that probably won't help.
Oh, God, Jerry, you know, that's not fucking neglectful childhood. Honestly, I was terrible. When I was a kid, I thought, you know, as every kid does, fucking, I know everything, whatever, I don't care.
You what?
Like, you know, like when you're a kid and you just don't give a shit and whatever.
Really?
Yeah, like, you know, like, I used to eat my lunch and come home from school and then just, without asking, just go and get, like, another packet of Christmas yogurt every day and just eat loads of crap and then mom would go...
I used to do that.
Do you realise that you're going to, you know, regret that when you're older? Yeah, whatever, you know, when you're a kid.
Really?
And then all of a sudden you get older and you go, actually, yeah, I kind of do.
Yeah.
So that's where shit that comes from.
Yeah.
Just like not caring and then realising actually, yeah, I do.
Yeah.
And then doing something about it after the event.
After the event.
That's pretty much it. Well, I suppose it's like creating a fresh scar over an old one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Kind of thing, really, ain't it, really?
Yeah.
Yeah. If you think about it logically.
Yeah. If you do think about it logically, that is exactly what it is. Getting my back tattooed on Sunday, which I'm not looking forward to.
Yeah, I was going to say actually, before I leave, I want to have a look at that if I can.
Yeah, just out of curiosity.
I've always seen pictures and stuff, but it's obviously different in real life. Isn't it?
It's very different in real life.
How is the experience generally, in fact, generally? Any
shit.
Areas, what, anywhere,
very, very,
anywhere.
Very bad.
Really?
Yeah.
What, anywhere generally?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah. Extremely bad.
Is that kind of a...
The worst pain I've ever felt.
Oh, really?
And my neck. The side of my neck was really bad
as
well.
Oh, God, yeah. Well, that's just, yeah.
That's just a gimmick.
It looks good, though. I quite like it. It's nice.
Yeah, it's just a cover-up, man.
No, but I mean, the actual, like, work
pattern,
and
idea
and stuff. Yeah, it's cool. Because the artist that done it is into...
geometric pattern.
Yeah. Is that all they do?
Yeah, I think so, yeah. They do, like, portraits and stuff, patterns, yeah. But he'll do it in that style kind of thing.
No, it's good, man. It's good. I thought it was quite cool.
It's different, yeah. It's a cool style to do, man.
And don't forget also, you say it hurt, because don't forget if there's a cover that's going over on scar tissue again. So.
Yeah, exactly, man. Yeah. Exactly. Here's Johnny.
Hello, good evening, welcome.
Yeah. Hello, good evening, welcome. Do you want to come out that door? Come through it properly and not chop it down? Shining, isn't it? If you haven't seen that, you don't know what the fuck I'm on about.
Oh no, I'm aware of that
one. You're fully aware. Here's Johnny.
Elizabeth.
Here's Elizabeth. Hello.
Take this statement as you will.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not looking forward to the helmet.
The what?
The helmet.
I get it.
Oh, we're on the same
page.
Try not to get your wires crossed. Do that.
Billions.
That's dreadful stuff.
Fuck it, I like it. It's very
good. Yeah, all very good. Awesome. There you go.
Not looking forward to the helmet.
Here, boy. Oh, we've got some more Cliff info here.
Go on.
He's obviously listening to being an earwig.
Yeah.
I loved having my back tattooed. The vibration on the spine was fucking awesome.
Fuck that.
Hashtag,
he's a liar.
What are you talking about?
He's a liar. Hashtag liar.
You describe the pain though, in terms of like just
shit,
intense?
Yeah, very intense. I can't really describe it.
It's no,
very,
it's subjective, isn't it?
It's very, very fucking sore, that's what it is. I just cannot explain it. Just brutal. Brutality. It just feels like the skin is very sensitive on the back.
I'm quite surprised.
On the back?
I don't know why. Maybe down the bottom of the back, yeah, I can understand that, but I wouldn't have thought like in the middle and the top stuff.
No, it's very really? Shit, yeah. The middle, actually, I got tattooed without, like, quickly on the middle, but one side was okay, and the other side was brutal, like, to the point I couldn't eat, it was unbearable. There wasn't much I could do in terms of...
Oh, hang on, incoming call. Sorry, mate.
It's all right.
Hello. I did just message you, what's up? I said, like, drink for the drink or eat something, like, should we do it for the other backup? What's up? It sounded soulful.
Yeah, Mark, I feel your pain, bro.
Mm-hmm. Not necessarily, just yet, I will keep you informed. Why not? What can you do to it? What can someone say? Why not? You don't have to. You don't want her to, then you're gonna have to do it. So why would you be so aggressive with it? If it doesn't seem like it, like, what if it should be something?
Ouch, bro.
Yeah.
Ouch, bro. Ouchie. Actually, is that bad? Ah. Just go this way a bit more again. My bad, my bad. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
It's not as well. It actually is.
Didn't shave that high up here. Hell yeah.
We are nearly there.
If you Google being kicked in the nuts versus childbirth pain,
is that for real though? Is being kicked in the nuts worse than childbirth?
Well, I've read it.
Really?
Then you can't fucking do it.
Yeah, can I do it? No, you can't.
Yeah, actually.
My poor ball.
No, you genuinely don't.
My poor ball.
You didn't have to have a baby for me. What strange way to say it. You can't do that.
My poor balls. I didn't even touch you, and you went, ah,
no. No, I know, I didn't even freaking do anything.
Four is a magic number.
Yes, it is. What do you mean I'm not allowed to pay me? Who gets pay me before being kicked in the nuts? It's not ridiculous in itself. There's nothing like it. Way worse. Being kicked in the nuts is a bitch. But how would you know? You haven't got them.
You haven't got nuts, bitch.
Because I watched you go for it. Well, to watch, yeah. You know, it doesn't mean anything, I don't know what it felt like. I know what it felt like to watch, but that's it. I didn't like it. It's fun. You were doing it once. I've never seen someone fill up their ears crying, but that's the first one.
Flip their ears crying?
No, when my girlfriend gave birth, she was crying that badly that when she turned to the side, it was a tear rolling down through an upper ear, like her ear up.
Wow.
So I'm not like down a canal, but you know, with a little curve.
Yeah. That's crazy, man.
That's I'm not brutal. Talking about during that, I'm talking about after.
After the sale of repairs.
Yes. Oh, so you can take my cat in, I can't take my cat in. You haven't got much, you don't know what size, are you? No, I don't. But I am one, though. That's what I can do, that's in the summer. You know the summer?
What's that?
Appendix.
No.
Not, oh, stop making women sound like they're so hard done by. Not every woman has to go through that. Yeah,
period.
You know. Yeah. It is raining. Yes, it is. It's not
coming down,
it's just
sitting.
Is it?
Yeah, it's
raining. For God's sake. That's your barbecue. Hello. Is she coming?
This is right in the crease. The battery crease.
Right in the crease, is it?
Yeah,
right.
Right in the better piece.
Half of it's controlling the breathing, isn't it?
Yeah.
You can get your breathing under control.
If you tense up, that's the most. This is what people don't understand. When you pass out, it's because you're tensing the body, so it's your fight and flight coming in after it's tensing so long.
I get
that. If you just breathe right, and try and breathe
right.
It'll definitely, and don't try not to tense up and always think about it.
Yeah.
You hardly ever pass that.
You're what? Did you say what I think you said? Well, can you show me? That's not fair, is it? Why are you doing that? We'll go further down than that and do that.
Whoa, what's love?
You were talking to me, and then it said Chloe was calling, and then I answered it, and it said end call with you, and then you come back.
Stupid.
You know yesterday or the day before when I said you should get a twin? Is this now happening? Are you the other one? Are you the other Chloe?
Go this way a bit more. That's the kitty.
Is that alright?
Yeah. Yes, sir.
Yeah. What can I see? And? Not for anyone else but me, is it? Maybe a little fun. Right, and it will go. I don't know if they're going to keep up. Yes, they do. Yes, they do. You delete out your gallery and you go into your cycle bin and then you delete out there, that's fine. Huh? passed out. I love how you say it's raining now, I'm not coming out tonight. This is a completely different type of thing. Well, exactly, it's still not me out of it. My birthday is always either catastrophically rubbish or it's sun is anything. Sun is anything? Sun is anything. Well, I don't know actually. Does that matter? Why does that matter? Well, I don't know. And nor can I find out, so if you like, it's not hard enough to wait. Because I don't even know myself, so I don't know, you don't know.
And we don't know, they don't know.
Why does it matter? But why? But why? For what purpose?
Just come back again.
That's a normal background.
Yeah.
So. Who's going in the dressing gown? Can you imagine standing up in a dressing gown? So I say, you've got your cream. Have you got any cream? Soak it in a tissue and salty water. I said salty water. What, salt water? Okay. I said salt water.
Salty water.
That's salt in it, not burning.
This is probably going to...
No, it's alright, it's not too too bad, but it's gonna get up.
Go through with some details and a bit of white.
Cool little bro.
That's a feeling, bro.
Yeah, it's all right.
Good, yeah?
Yeah, it's cool. Yeah, it's cool, cool. You just said something, so. What did you say? After what? There isn't one. It's literally fair game on whatever I think. Whatever you literally is, whatever. What? I didn't say that. I said whatever. Literally, if you want to do something else, you can. I don't know whatever you want to say. That's the white one, isn't it?
No.
Oh, no. I don't know.
Yeah.
I don't know why, I just...
What's that? Saw?
No, yeah, a little bit.
No.
No, no, I think... I thought it was opposite to it. Where did you know?
How you feeling, bro?
Shit. Yeah, no, it's alright. It's just still in some areas, yeah, but it's alright. It's alright.
Thank you, man. It's okay, it's okay. As long as you're good, I saw that, man. It's really good.
Mm-hmm.
Very nearly done.
then I'll let you jump in. Yeah, I'm important.
Thanks, Max Smith. I'm just gonna whack some white in now to just really pop it out, make it look super realistic. And what I use is Dynamic White. Good stuff. And a quick tip for putting white in, I always use a fresh needle so there's no cross contamination with. I'm going to use a 9 round liner on this one. Let's try and get 100 likes on the video, guys, if you're watching. I've got 97. 3 more likes. And consider subscribing. I do videos like this every day, near enough. They're not actually cracks. These are just my reference lines, so I've drawn them on myself. I'd be worried if I was in war with a gas mask on with a cracked helmet. I'd want it fully intact.
No, it's all right, actually.
It's all right.
Once one section goes into the next, it's, you know, just trying to start a blur. Yeah, it's all right. It's kind of just gone.
Okay. Well, that's good.
Right, last bit.
Cool, yeah.
The white time.
Coolio and the gang. Pops it out a bit more. How's it feeling, my brother?
Yeah, it's actually alright.
It's alright, yeah?
Yeah, it's not too bad.
Sweet Caroline. Doo-doo-dee. La 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 la. So good, so good, so good. Sweet Caroline. Ma, ma, ma.
Yeah.
I have no idea, brother.
How you feeling, brother?
Yeah, it's alright.
Cool.
Actually,
surprisingly, it's alright. Alright, cool.
I think we're about there, bro.
Mm-hmm.
Smashed it again.
Cool.
Smashed the shit.
Dash it.
Well done. Sound like a fucking champ again.
Again, ladies and gentlemen. Bloody game. You're only supposed to blow the bleeding gold.
This is the full piece. If you can see. Thank you very much for the likes, over 100 now, that's awesome. And thank you for that guy that sent that donation of 93p, that was lovely. Thank you so much for that. This has already healed this section. So we've got this section we've just done today, which is in a ditch of the knee, which wasn't nice. How, on the scale of pain scale, 1 to 10, how much was it? How sore was it?
Slow. And got the mushroom cloud at the top, the bottom. Yeah. Do this. Still a bit bloody, but very nice indeed. Very nice indeed.
That's going to heal perfectly, I can tell already. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Have a great weekend. Peace out.